Hello students, I'm here with another video from the chapter in our environment from class 10th NCERT book. Before starting today's video, I would like to tell you all that till now what all things we have studied in this lesson so far. So we have covered the topic our environment with the definition. We started with the definition as it says that environment means the surrounding where we live. Now, if we are living in a surrounding, we are interacting with the living as well as non-living things. Okay, so if we talk about the living things, it is known as biotic factors, and if we talk about non-living things, it is known as abiotic factors. So in the environment, we can see that there is interaction between the biotic as well as abiotic factors in a very large span. We can say that there is the large amount of interaction between the plants as well as in the animals and among the abiotic factors and the biotic factors. For example, if we take a very easy and very simple example that we are breathing in oxygen. From where we are getting this oxygen? We are getting it from a living being, that is a plant. Okay, now if we talk about the plant, it is doing photosynthesis. How it is doing photosynthesis, how it is releasing energy, how it is releasing oxygen? It is releasing oxygen because of the interaction between the abiotic factors such as the soil, sunlight, water, all these things. Okay, so if we talk about the interactions, there could be numerous interactions, and some of the interactions, we cannot live our life without these types of interaction between biotic as well as abiotic factors. In the same concept, we have studied about the different types of ecosystem where the interaction is being seen. So there are different types of ecosystems such as terrestrial ecosystem and the aquatic ecosystem. If we talk about terrestrial ecosystem, this is an ecosystem which is present on the surface of the earth, that is, it is present in the land. For example, the desert, forest, grasslands, all these are the examples of the terrestrial ecosystem. Now if we talk about the aquatic ecosystem, it means that there are, again, it is divided into two parts, that is, one is a freshwater ecosystem and the another one is the marine water ecosystem. Marine water ecosystem consists of the salt water where the seas and the oceans will come. And if we talk about the freshwater ecosystem, there the lakes, ponds, as well as the springs, even the rivers also will come under the same category. Now, when we have talked about the ecosystem, I have told you that these ecosystem can work only because of the three main features, that is the producers, consumers and the decomposers. Now, whenever the producer is there, it is always a green plant. And this producer could be directly related with the consumers, and these consumers again were of three, four types. Then first was the primary consumer, then secondary consumer, then tertiary consumers and the quaternary consumer. Now if we talk about the interaction between these producers and consumers, we could say that we need to talk about the food chain also. So if we are studying about the food chain as it is given here at the back of this slide, this food chain consists of the interaction between, it shows the relationship between the biotic as well as abiotic factors. Where biotic factors always starts from the producer, this food chain always starts from the producer, then it goes to primary consumer, then it goes to secondary consumer, then it goes to tertiary consumer, and lastly it goes to the quaternary consumers. But remember that I told you that in this concept that the food chain is not going to be away from more than that of this quaternary consumer. So this is the last step where the energy of an ecosystem starts decreasing, or it is nil about, it is about, means you can say it's very less. The energy which is present in each and every ecosystem is in each and every level of the food chain, it is going to, it goes on decreasing. And at the last step, it is where it is least, okay? It is the least energy which you could see at the last level of ecosystem. Fine. So this food chain, okay? So food chain could be of different types, and you could make many food chains. I have given you as a homework also to complete that different types of food chain in your copy. Now, if we talk about some more things in today's video, that will start from the same concept that these producers, consumers, and the tertiary consumers are present. Where are these present? Each and every step of this this food chain is known as the trophic level. Now, if we talk about the trophic level, what is it? It is the each step of the food chain is known as the trophic level. And today we will deal with the food web also. Then also, each step of the food web and the food chain is known as the trophic level. So, if we talk about the trophic level, it means that it is the step. Without the trophic levels, we cannot complete. We cannot move from one level to another level, or we cannot see the interaction between the organisms in a food chain. So it is the trophic level which gives us the information about the interaction between the animals, the plants, the producers, the consumers, the primary, secondary, and the tertiary consumers. Okay, now if we talk about the levels, the level first is with the producers. So at the very first, at the base, the producers lie. After that, primary consumer, then secondary consumer, then the tertiary consumer. And as we are moving upwards from the producer till the tertiary consumer, the number of the consumers, the number of the animal goes on decreasing. Okay, and if we find, you can also see that the grasses or the plants are very, they are very in large number. I want to say that they are present in a very large number. Now, if we talk about the herbivores, they are less in comparison to the grass, okay? And if you just move on to the field, just to see the field which is full of grass, and if you start counting those grass, I think the counting would be over, but the grass strands would not be over. Because a small patch of grassland may have a number of grass strands which is very much more than that of the animals, herbivorous animals. So these animals are, if we move on from one trophic level to the another trophic level, the number of organism, the number of animals goes on decreasing. And this happens just because that the producers are largest, they are in large number, okay? To sustain the complete ecosystem, it is necessary for the producer to give energy, to produce energy, okay? So therefore, the producers are always in large number. Now we move on to the next part, that is the food web. So we have talked enough about the food chain. We have also seen the significance of the food chain in the last class. So that is important to sustain the life on the earth. It is very much important. These food chains are important for the energy flow. Now I'll deal with the energy flow in this topic. I mean, in today's video, I'll also give you some of the points to understand that how is this energy flow taking place. Okay. As you know that energy flow is taking place from one trophic level to the another trophic level. When we move from one trophic level to another trophic level, the energy transfer takes place. It's but obvious, because when we are moving from one trophic level to another trophic level, the energy transfer has to take place. Every time the energy is going to be consumed. Now that energy, whatever energy which a producer has to go. This producer has to pass its energy. They will all pass its energy to the consumers. And these consumers are going to pass energy to the next consumer. Okay, and this could pass to the next consumer. Fine. So every time the energy is being passed, and we have also seen that producers also have to participate in their own life process. So here also some energy will be lost. Now what amount of energy is going to supply? We will just talk about all these things in the next few slides. Okay, now I must say that it is very definite that the energy transfer is taking place, and it is in unidirectional. Why it is in unidirectional? Because the producers are going to give food to the consumer. Because consumers are not able to make their own food. That is why the producers are the ones who are these plants are only give they only give food to the another animals, that is the consumer. Okay, So this is because the energy, once the energy flow takes place, and again the second function, main function of the food chain was the nutrient cycling. Now this nutrient cycling is again a very vast step. I mean, this is a very vast topic, and it will be covered one by one when I'll tell you about the biogeochemical cycles. Then the nutrient cycling will be very much clear to everyone. Fine. Now, if we talk about the food web now, so the food web means, as the web, this word web is saying, this web means it is the interconnection. Web means the spider's web. If we talk about the web, web is always used with the spider's home, isn't it? How does it looks like? It look like? So it looks like just a net-like structure. If you see that, it always look like a net-like structure. Okay. Now you will see that it is always attached from the center to the boundary. Now here you will see that each and every thread is attached with each other. Whether it is a very large web or a small web, it is always connected with each other. Each and every thread is interconnected with each other. Now, web is such an interconnection. Again, the food related interconnection between the different food chain is known as the food web. So, what does this mean? This means that the interconnection of the food chain, when it is operating in an ecosystem which establish a network of relationship between various species, is called food web. Okay, so this food web means that it is the connection between the ecosystem. It is the ecosystem, the food chains are operating in an ecosystem. Just think like that. There could be many of the food chains working together. How this is possible? Just think over it. I'll just take one example first. So this example will make it very clear to all of you what does the food web means. So we'll just take up this example first, and then I'll explain you what is the meaning of the food web according to the text which is written over there. So when we talk about the food web, as I said, that web means interconnections. Okay, it means interconnection. Now, what kind of interconnection? Interconnection of food. Okay, interconnection of food. Now, how is this food being interconnected? Let us see this. So the food is being interconnected to each others because of the food habits, you could say. Okay, now if we see this green plant, which is a producer, this producer is going to give food to many of the herbivorous animal at a single time. Now, if we talk about the food web in forest, for in forest there would be a variety of animals. The single tree is going to serve to the goat. The single tree is going to serve to the rabbit. A single tree is going to serve to the small mouse also of the forest. Why? Because mouse has to feed on grains. Okay. Then this rabbit will feed on the leaves. Similarly, goat is also going to feed on the leaves. Now, if a plant is present, it is serving three animals at a time. This is just for an example. It is serving numerous of animals at a single time. Now, the food chain says it is an interconnection between who eats whom. Now, here, this goat will be eaten up by another carnivorous animal. Okay, for example, jackal. Next is the rabbit, which is a small animal. It is again being feeded. It could be eaten up by the jackal. Okay, or a fox, wildcat, anything it could be, which is bigger than this. All these are the herbivorous animals, and the next step will be the carnivorous animals. So these carnivorous animals are going to eat up these herbivorous animals, as they are the secondary consumers. Okay, they are the secondary consumers. Now what happens? The small mouse is eaten up by another carnivorous animal, that is owl. It could be eaten up by the wildcat, it could be eaten up by the jackal. Okay. Similarly, all these big animals will be eaten up by another big animal. This goat would be eaten up by another big animal. Okay. So again, you will see that this has a top carnivore. Okay. This could be the tertiary carnivore. Next, the mouse could be eaten up by the snake also at the same time. This snake would be eaten up by the kite, eagle, or peacock. Fine. Again, this becomes the top carnivore. Okay. So this is how you could see that a numerous of food chain is working together. So the one, so one food chain could be the goat. This could be the tree, goat, jackal, lion. Again, this is the one food chain. Second, the tree, goat, directly to the lion. So this is another food chain. Next, rabbit, jackal, sorry, this producer. We'll first take producer, that is the green plant, then rabbit, then jackal, then lion. This is the third food chain. Fourth, this rabbit, this grass, then rabbit, then this wildcat, then lion. Fourth food chain. Then fifth, the rabbit, and directly if it goes to the lion, fifth food chain. Now if we move on to the mouse, this grains, then mouse, then to the owl. This owl is eaten up by the snake, it is eaten up by the kite. Okay, similarly, so there are many ways at the same, see, six food chains are working together at the same time, which depends directly upon this plant. And this is satisfying six food chains at the same time. This is just an example. There could be numerous more food chains working in our forest with a single tree. As you could see that these are interconnected with each other, and it's very easy, it's very simple to understand this food web with the same example. So it just looks like a web. Okay, it is looking like a web. And if we talk about that it looks like a web, so what happens? This becomes, all these are interconnected because of the food habits. One is the food for the another. Trophic level, each of them is a trophic level. So here one trophic level producer, then second is the consumer, tertiary consumer, quaternary consumer. Okay, so these all are known as the trophic level. Each step of food chain or the food web is known as the trophic level. Now we have talked about the trophic level, it means that the energy needs to transfer from one trophic level to the another trophic level. Now food web is an interconnection between the various food chains, and this is related with the interconnection of the food habits. Okay, so one is being eaten up by the another animal, and if one of the, or you could say that who eats whom, this law works in the forest very easily. Now I will go back to the slide. As I told you that what is written in the text form we'll study after this example. So we have seen an example of food web now, and we can easily understand what is given there in this text. So I'll quickly read this out, and I make sure that you all understand what is this food web about. Okay, so this food web is an interconnection of the food chains operating in an ecosystem which establish a network of relationship between various species is known as the food web. As you have seen here, there are many numerous of species are present in that forest, and that is working on the same tree. This tree is going to sustain the life cycle of each of the herbivorous animals, which as in turn this herbivorous is able to satisfy the needs of the carnivorous animals. And this is how this becomes interconnection between various food chains, and the food web is going to work. Okay, in a food web, an organism may occupy a position more than in one food chain. Okay, so here also, as you could see, this rabbit could be the food for jackal, it could be the food for wildcat, it could be directly the food for the rabbit, this lion. Okay, so you could see that one single animal is a food for many other animals in a forest or in an ecosystem or in the food chain, in the food web. So this food web is an organization. It is the way by which it is establishing a relationship between various species which forms the food source, and in turn it may be eaten up by different types of organisms. So that is why the animals are being eaten up by the different types of organisms, and they are going to give rise to a food web. And you could draw many such food webs in various ecosystems. I have given you the example of the food web in the forest. You could draw the food web in the water, in the aquatic ecosystem. You could draw the food web in the grassland ecosystem. Okay, grassland ecosystem. You could draw the food web in the desert ecosystem. Okay, and just think over the producers, consumers, and the decomposers present in the desert condition, and you will be able to draw the food web very easily. And that will be the homework for you all, to draw at least 3 food webs from different ecosystem which you have studied. Okay, so it could be from aquatic, it could be from the terrestrial, it could be from the grassland ecosystem. I have shown you one example of the forest ecosystem, and one food web I have expressed. Now I move on to the next topic, that is again I'll move on to the next slide, that is again going to show you one more food web. As different flowering plants are present, different herbivorous, these herbs are present, these plants are present, which could be food for many of these animals at the same time. Now this grass, this corn plant is there, a flowering plant is there, then these lavenders are there, which are just the wild weed type of plants, and then it could be some fruits. So what happens to it? So this corn is a food for the grasshopper. This grasshopper is eaten up by other animal. Okay, so this corn plant is eaten up by the grasshopper. This grasshopper is eaten up by the rat. This rat is eaten up by the snake. Okay, this snake is eaten up by the eagle. Fine. Now next, what happens? This grasshopper is eaten up by the frog. It could be eaten up by the frog also. Okay, so this frog will be eaten up by the snake. Again, it will be eaten up by the python eagle. Fine. So there you have seen that two food chains are working together. Now what, suppose if this rat is directly eaten up by this eagle, this rat could be eaten up by the wolf. Okay, so you could see that all these are forming interconnection. One animal is the food for the another animal. One animal is the food for other animal. Okay, so here the food chain only is giving you the relationship between the different food chains, which forms a network of food chain is known as the food web. As this name is very clearly saying, that it is the interconnection, as the web is having interconnection between the threads, and it is again each and every thread is interrelated with each other. Similarly, these food webs are interrelated with each other. Now we move on to the next flowering plant, and this becomes the food for this butterfly, as it is having the flowers, and these flower will be the nectar will be sucked up by these butterflies. So this butterfly could be eaten up by the dragonfly. This dragonfly is eaten up by the bird. This bird is small bird is eaten up by the big bird. Similarly, this butterfly could this frog is going to eat up this butterfly. Okay, now just remember that we are drawing this this arrow in the forward direction only. There is no other way to backflow of the energy. So please remember, you have to draw the arrows in the forward direction. This is going to tell you the energy is flowing only in one direction. Now why this is happening? This is happening because if the energy has to flow, it has to flow only from the producer to the consumer, because producers are the ones which are giving energy, which are preparing food. It is going to give the energy to the consumers, because consumers are directly eating the grass, it is directly eating the plant products, and then if the plant products are directly eaten, it means the energy is also directly going inside the body of the herbivorous animals. So these animals are going to pass the energy to the next carnivorous animal. Then that carnivorous animal is going to be eaten up by another top carnivorous animals. So you could see that the small carnivorous animal is not able to eat that top carnivore. So the top carnivore is a stronger one. It is going to eat the weaker one. So here what happens, energy always flows in only in one direction. Please remember, that is why we have drawn all the arrows in the forward direction. So this butterfly is eaten up by the frog. This frog is eaten up by another animal. Again, that another animal is eaten up by the large animal, big animal. So again, this lavender also could be a flowering plant. It is always attracted by the beautiful butterflies. So these butterflies will be eaten up by the dragonflies, or it could be eaten up by the frog. Okay, so what happens? It is going to be the food for the another next animal. These mangoes or the fruits are the producers, and they will be attracted by the fruit fly. This fruit fly again could be eaten up by the frog, or it could be directly eaten up by the bird, or it could be eaten up by the dragonfly. And all these could be eaten up by the bird, and the small bird and the big bird. Okay, so this bird could be eaten up by the wolf, and this wolf could be eaten up by some of the pythons, which are very large in number, which are very large in their size. So we could say that one animal is the food for the another animal in the food chain, and food web is the interconnection of many such food chains which are working together in that particular ecosystem, whether it is a forest ecosystem, whether it is the aquatic ecosystem, whether it is the terrestrial ecosystem. Okay, if we talk about the different ecosystem, we could see that many food chains are working together. Okay, now I'll just discuss the difference between the food chain and the food web in this slide. So here, the first difference of the food chain says, the food chain is defined as a phenomenon of transfer of energy through a series of organisms falling on successive trophic levels. What is this successive trophic level? Successive trophic levels means one after another. For example, the grass was eaten up by the cow or the goat. This goat was eaten up by the lion. Okay, so the food chain is going to define as a transfer of energy from one trophic level to the another trophic level. On the successive trophic level, please remember. So this successive trophic level is going to help in the formation, in the consumption of the energy, and this energy is always being transferred in the forward direction. So this next is the food web, is an interconnection of the food chain which shows the relationship between them. So food web is an interconnection of the food chain which shows the relationship between each other. Okay. So food web is always the relationship between the different types of food chains. Next, difference is, in food chains, it usually member of the higher trophic level feeds upon the single type of organisms in the lower trophic level. So if you're talking about a single food chain, it means that there would be few animals. Similarly, if we talk about the food web, in the food web, the higher trophic levels may feed upon many of the lower organisms in the lower trophic level. As you could see that one, this frog is a food for eagle, this could be the food for python at the same time, or this small butterfly could be the food for dragonfly, frog, or it could be the food for directly to the bird. Okay, so as it is very easy to understand that food web means it is the interconnection between different animals, and large number of animals are participating in this food, forming this food web. So the one animal has a better chance of survival as it is having more options for the food to be eaten up. I mean, it has more chance for its food. One single animal could be eaten up by many other animals, or you could say that many animals could feed upon that single particular animal. Okay, it could be the food for other animals. Fine. So next is that third point says, in the food chain, it separates and isolates the food chain, increases in instability in the ecosystem. How this is increasing instability? Because if one of the animal, one of the trophic level gets disturbed, it is going to disturb the complete food chain. But in the food web, no such problem is going to arise, as there could be many other options for one single animal. Okay, if this lion is not going to get the wolf to be eaten up, means it is not going to get the wolf for either purpose, same purpose, then what happens? It could satisfy its hunger with another animal. Okay, it could eat another animal. Similarly, this eagle could have many other options, and the more trophic level is going to increase, I mean the last trophic level has much more options for the food. More food material could be obtained, as you could see that eagle can eat this small bird, it could eat this wolf, it could eat this snake, it could eat this small dragonfly also directly. So the top carnivore has more options for the food. So please remember that whenever the food chain is there, there the instability is not present. Why? Because the single animal has more option for the food purpose. Next topic of this fourth point says, fourth difference says, it comprises of only one food chain. As a few animals are present, so food chain has only one food, means we are just seeing the energy flow in one way or in the one part only. Now if we talk about the food web, there what happens in the food web, the stability, it comprises of many food chain. Okay, so there could be many animals are present, which helps in the sustenance of the food web. Similarly, the last difference says, the removal of one of the group may disturb the whole food chain because there could be few animals only. So each animal has to stay in the food chain as it is a food for the another animal. The another animal is not having other option for the food. But in food web, if one animal is removed, it is not going to disturb the food chain that much. But it is going to affect the food chain, but not in the greater extent. Okay, so please remember that these are the ways by which we could differentiate between the food chain and the food web. Okay, so this was all about the difference between the food chain and the food web, children. Okay, so we have discussed many things about this food chain and the food web now, and I hope you all have understood that food chain is a single, we are talking about a single chain, single interconnection, but food web could be interaction or the interconnection between many organisms at the same time. So that's all for today's video, children. I will meet you all in the next video with the next topic to be discussed. That's all for today's video.